Please get ready for transcription number 342 at 80 words per minute. 5 seconds. Start. Now I come to the question of railway accidents. The railway ministry has been for some time now wanting to wash out what they call external inspection. You will remember that on the floor of the house, I had asked more than once questions about the government inspectorate, but all sorts of funny arguments were advanced. In the original committee's report, a very strong recommendation was made that the position of these government inspectors should be strengthened in the interest of safety of travel. It is unfortunate that we do not have the facts and figures given by them. It is very unfair not to let us know what the recommendation is and to withhold from the House the arguments which they have given, the facts and figures which they have given, and the material on which those recommendations are based, that has been withheld. But now the reviewing committee wants not to strengthen the government inspectors, to wash them out as independent units and to bring them back under the control of the railway administration, that they should be a branch of the railway board. There is a very long history behind this. It was only in 1941 that they were taken away from the control of the railway administration and put under a separate ministry, the Ministry of Communications. I have gone into the arguments which have been advanced by the reviewing committee and Mr. Deputy Chairman. I can tear them to pieces. They say that in the present state of affairs, it is impossible for any external inspection to carry out a really sound examination and inspection, but they forget that they are mixing supervision with inspection. The argument that they have advanced is that under a system of external inspection, a real and sound supervision from stage to stage cannot be done. They say that they must have this sort of setup. By all means, let them have it, but external inspection serves a different purpose. I may submit for your information that in 1945, the views of the general managers of all the government railways were taken in the matter, and all the general managers were of the view that the inspectorate must be maintained. Another committee which they appointed, on which some foreign experts also served, went to the extent of advising the railway administration, these inspectors have to criticize the railway board. Even the highest officers in the railway administration, and now if they are transferred back, we can imagine the situation when even the report of a committee which was appointed with the knowledge of Parliament and on which so many persons served is being shelved and suppressed. Do you think that any independent inspection notes will ever see the light of the day? They say that in case of major accidents, we can have judicial inquiries. Inspection is one thing, and an inquiry into a major accident is another. The inspectorate that exists now is absolutely necessary, and it must be absolutely independent so that it can criticize the railway board or even the highest of the officers, the chief engineer or the general manager of the railway concerned. As for judicial inquiries, if they are necessary, by all means have them. I have been an advocate of it. I have been associated all my life with the judiciary. I have risen from a magistrate. I started my career as a magistrate, and I would always advocate judicial inquiry when it is necessary. But certainly judicial inquiry cannot replace inquiry of a technical nature. And if you have a judicial inquiry, you will always want some technical experts to be the assessors or to be associated with that inquiry so that they guide and give an independent view. Do you want the officers of the railway ministry to be assessors, or do you want independent assessors? These government inspectors would be absolutely independent assessors in those judicial inquiries. This is just one part of it. There are at least half a dozen important matters which should be referred to. I will now refer to another matter on which, fortunately, the original committee and the reviewing committee are in agreement. I am not concerned with this or that committee. I am concerned only with the safety of travelling, and I very much welcome that there is agreement on some points which I consider to be very important, and that is about the adequate and full supplies of stores essential for safety and good performance. If you read the recommendations of both these committees, you will find that this serious lag has been responsible for a lot of inefficiency, for some of the accidents, and for keeping our personnel idle for a long time. Stop.